Okay, we're in the kitchen whipping up another Super Bowl spectacular. This time, we're talking pinwheels. And again, it's the cream cheese, just like your dip, that makes it. I just sampled one.
This is Sassy Mamas. This is a take on her claim to fame.
It is, yeah.
So you have a famous recipe that
I
love for Super Bowls. Tell us about it.
Well, my Sassy Tailgate sandwiches, about 9 years ago, I entered a contest. People ask all the time, how did I get this gig?
Right.
Entered this contest with Paula Deen.
Oh.
I won it. Won $25,000, and the rest is history. And this recipe was so good to Paula that she served it at her niece's wedding.
Oh, wow.
It's so good.
And she still asked me, I mean, she and I have stayed friends through the years, but yes, this is a claim to fame that I have, and it's these Sassy Tailgate sandwiches. But I have to tell you, my friend Rita Brooks, who's a family friend of ours, she tweeted me and she said, you know, Karen, sometimes I make these and I use bread dough instead of the Hawaiian roll sandwiches.
Okay.
Then she said, and sometimes I use crescent rolls. And I was like, Rita, that's genius.
Yeah, so
pinwheels.
This is a variation.
Pinwheels. Mm-hmm. So this is a variation thanks to Rita. And again, that is the biggest compliment for me in my recipe is that, you know, when you try to make it your own, that's what I want, guys.
Right.
There's no, so what you're going to do is you're going to take your crescent rolls just like this and spread it out. Make sure and work with a cold crescent roll or they're very bossy.
Mm-hmm.
So what I do is I use parchment paper just like this and I'm gonna roll it out just slightly, not a ton, but when I roll it, what you're doing is you're really making the creases tight.
You're making it all one piece.
One piece.
Okay.
So now what we're gonna do, this was, you know, the contest was with Philadelphia cream cheese and so what I used was the chive and onion.
Oh, that makes it.
You're just going to take it just like this, and you're going to spread it all over, just like that. And then, do you want to open up that ham for me? Now, this is my trick, because I've literally made zillions, not even thousands, zillions of pans of these. In fact, I was told that Sam started carrying the multi-pack, the bigger packs of King Hawaiian because of my recipe.
What?
Here in Oklahoma. They went so quickly.
They needed them.
Yeah.
John, do we have some scissors around here?
Uh-oh.
Is that kind of zips off
of
your
eye?
I zipped it, and I can't.
Or not.
Hold on.
Here, let me see if I can get it.
Oh, there we go. Use the knife. Use the big tools.
Mm, try that.
So what you're going to do,
what kind of dip?
Gruyere cheese, grated.
Right up your alley.
And Swiss. Now, Gruyere is expensive. It's hard to find. If you cannot find Gruyere, don't fret. Just use Swiss.
Use Swiss, but you still want it grated. Okay.
Grated, just like this, and I press it in.
We have ham.
Do we have ham now, Sissy?
Woo!
So what you're going to do is you're going to preheat your oven to 375 degrees. You're going to line that baking sheet.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. I know.
Is that your favorite dish?
Did you just try the cream cheese in it?
Here, may I have some more ham?
Oh, sure. That's from the last segment, if you missed that.
I made David. You're like a kid at Christmas.
Wow. That is so good.
I know. Just think if I had the white chocolate and you make the laces.
No, don't even tease me.
Don't even tease me now. Okay, now you're going to twist it this way so you can get more pinwheels.
Oh,
just like this, guys. And what I do is I use my parchment paper.
Okay, I want to see you do this because a recipe told me to do it like that with the parchment paper and I couldn't do it for the life of me.
Okay, watch me. So I'm going to do this. I lay it down.
I hug it.
Hey, have you ever been to Qdoba?
Or to
Chipotle and they use the foil to roll?
We don't work there. We've been there.
Yeah.
I know, but I guess I watch.
You watch.
Well, of course you're learning from them.
And so they're using
that. Bit by bit.
Bit by bit.
Okay.
Cut it in half. Use a half a stick of butter, a little bit of onion salt, little variation from my recipe.
Yes, okay.
Parmesan cheese. Brush it on the cuts.
Okay.
Bake it for 10 minutes and boom.
You're there.
Your life has changed.
I'm not over that.
Try that.
Yeah.
I'm
might have
that.
A few of these.
I know. Is that the best football you've ever had?
That's the best football cow patty I've ever had.
I'm telling you what.
That is
these
so
good.
Good.